Hey guys, welcome to the Kids Corner. First we'll hear from Miss Luann, then we'll have a song.
Good morning, boys and girls of Gorman. I hope you're having a great morning this morning. I am so excited to think about that maybe before too long, who knows, we might get to be in Sunday school and I can give you a real hug instead of an air hug. But for right now, we're at Kids Corner this morning. We're going to talk about our special holiday this week, and it is tomorrow, which is National Napping Day. So you can take a nap. That's after you do your schoolwork. But why do we have a National Napping Day tomorrow? Because the time changed, which makes me so happy. We get more daytime. We get to be out longer. The day doesn't end so early, so I'm real excited about that. But we did lose an hour, so you may need to take a nap on National Napping Day. We're going to talk about another way that we can use our Bible in our lives. Last week, we talked about the Bible was a light. If you remember, we talked about how it could light our path and direct our way. We used it as an illustration like that, as a light. And we had some very good examples of that. Well, this week, we're going to talk about how our Bible can be used kind of like a warning sign. When you think about a warning sign, think about how important a warning sign is. A warning sign is to protect us. And so that we don't do something that may be dangerous. It may help us to protect other people. If there weren't for warning signs, we could really be hurt. Things could happen. I printed out some examples of warning signs. Caution. Need to take caution. Think about what you're doing. Be cautious. Danger. Power lines above. Well, that wouldn't be good if a power line fell on you. That would be bad. How about dead end? Dead end. You don't want to end up on a dead end. There's nothing down there. Slow down. Don't go too that. Going too fast may be harmful. Oh, here's the one we can really think about. Danger. Something may be poison. You don't want to eat something or drink something that is poison. You need to pay attention to the warning. Just danger, warning. Then there's the one that we all know. Stop. If you don't stop and pay attention to this one, bad things could happen. Oh, this is one that I think about a lot. Caution. I don't want to fall down and get hurt. I got too much to do. So there are lots of warning signs that we think about, that we see as we go around and we travel around. But you know, the Bible is also like it gives us some warning and some things that we need to be sure to pay attention to so that we don't get in situations that hurt ourselves, that endanger ourselves or someone else. We have several verses we're going to talk about this week. Deuteronomy, you better remember where Deuteronomy is now. You know where that book is. The fifth chapter, verses 32 and 33. So be careful to do what the Lord your God has commanded you. There's that word careful. Be cautious. Pay attention. Be careful to do what the Lord your God has commanded you. Do not turn aside to the right or to the left. Don't go over here or over here. Keep your eyes right focused on what God has in mind for you to do. Walk in all the way that the Lord your God has commanded you, so that you may live and prosper and prolong your days in the land that you will possess. You see, the Bible is saying, think about all the caution signs that we talked about. You may need to stop doing something. You know, we got some commandments that tell us what we're supposed to do and not do. Think about that. You may really need to study and slow down and study and think before you make a decision that you know is not pleasing to God. So our Bible, all through the scriptures, gives us warnings and cautions. It tells us there's some things we need to just stop doing, that we can't do that, not as a Christian. So last week our Bible was a light, and this week our Bible is like a warning or a caution sign. directing us to go in the right direction, telling us where we need to go and how to live. We want to be sure that we're living the way God wants us to. So we got to pay attention to the warnings that he gives us in the scriptures. Now we're going to go over to the book of Ephesians. Now you know that Ephesians is in the New Testament. Might be a little bit harder to find than Deuteronomy, but you can do it. I know you can. We were working on these in JAM, and we will work on them again. So Ephesians chapter 5, verse 15 through 17. Now listen, it starts again with, be very careful then how you live. Not as unwise, but as wise. That careful again. Be cautious. Pay attention. You may need to stop. You may need to slow down. You may need to be aware of something that is poison in what you're doing, and you don't need to do it. You need to get rid of it. Not as unwise, but as wise. Be cautious and careful to be wise, making the most of every opportunity, because the days are evil, and we know that there are some evil things in the world. Therefore, do not be foolish, but understand what the Lord's will is. How much plainer can it be that our Bible is like a warning or a caution sign? It is helping us to know what direction to go, how fast to go, when to slow down, how to not get on a dead end. Just follow the scriptures. I love this lesson. I'm going to think about it this week. Every time I see a caution sign, I'm going to think about it. How the Bible is not only a light, but it's also like a warning sign or a caution sign, directing us what's good to do and what's not good to do. Great lesson. I like it. Now, I want to give you a little challenge for Easter. We had a Valentine challenge. Sent out some great Valentine cards, made people happy. Your challenge, and we'll talk about it a little bit more next week, but think about these words. Get hopping. Get hopping. We may want to hop over and make a visit to someone that we've been missing at church. So we're going to talk about that next week, but just think about it. You need to get hopping and make a visit to someone you love. Bye.
Raindrops rolling off my brim. Street lights got the pavement glistening. Touchdown, I fall into your arms. Right where I belong, your everlasting arms. And where would I be without you? I'll be packing my bags when I need to stay. I'll be chasing every breeze that blows my way. I'll be I am yours forever.
Be sure to tune in to our morning worship service with music and Pastor Craig preaching.